In the name of God, the most gracious, the most merciful, welcome everybody to episode 2 of The Miracle of Life, The Placenta Equals the Breach, with myself, Muhammad Jabwata, second year medical student at UCT, with the help of the lecture of Prof. Graham Lowe, a lecturer at UCT. So, yesterday, right, we spoke about the fertilization, right, the beginning, when the sperm cell met with the egg cell to form a zygote, and then how that developed into different, how the growth of the cells occurred to form two layers, two germ layers over here. That's two layers, a bilaminar embryonic disc, as well as three layers after that. And while that occurs, there's something called implantation, where this ball of cells, right, called a blastocyst, right, it implants into the wall of the womb of the mother, called the endometrium, right? So, as you can see, it attaches to the wall of the mother. This blastocyst is busy now penetrating the wall of the mother, and as you can see now, growth of cells is going in the direction of the wall of the uterus, and it's now basically becoming implanted into the wall of the uterus. And what's very interesting is that there's so many mechanisms, so many signaling occurring for the attachment phase and the implantation phase. Look how amazing that is. So there we go again, from a ball of cells, it attaches to the wall of the mother, and then this ball of cells, right, it penetrates into the endometrium, into the wall of the womb of the mother. Now, after that, right, what happens is that as further growth and development occurs, what happens is the formation of the placenta, right? And as you can see over here, that this is the placenta that's going to form, right? And the placenta is basically a bridge between the mother, which is the side over here, and the fetus, the side over here. And if you look here, right, there's an umbilical vein which takes blood from, so basically blood basically goes from the mother, it goes into the space over here, right? So that's the mother's blood, and then that's the fetus, the fetal blood, or the blood of the fetus over there. And that green, the green over here is almost like a gateway between the mother's blood and the fetus and the blood of the fetus. There's no mixture of the mother's blood and the blood of the fetus. And gases such as oxygen, right, travels from the mother's blood to the fetus blood via a process like called diffusion into the umbilical vein. And that umbilical vein sends that red, it's red, so it's clean blood or oxygenated blood, it goes to the fetus. And that fetus needs oxygen for the survival of the fetus. And then that blood becomes deoxygenated or dirty, and then enters the umbilical artery again, going towards, right, going into this finger over here called a villus, and then it diffuses to the mother's blood again, that blue over there, and that dirty blood is now going to be cleaned by the mother's circulatory system with the help of the heart and the lungs. And that is very interesting. There's many other functions of the placenta, such as the transport of nutrients, because remember, the fetus must get nourished, so nutrients must move from the fetal, from the mother's blood to the fetus blood, as well as antibodies to protect against infection. There's also certain hormones that the placenta also perform, that the placenta also secrete. And that's but to mention a few of its functions. So I ask myself and yourself the question, who was the creator of this bridge? Who was the creator of this placenta? And every day I just ponder about this, just to be grateful for this miraculous creation. And I'd like to end off with the extra embryonic membranes. So this is the fetus, right? So there's the placenta, chorionic villi is like finger-like projections. The yolk sac is what provides nutrients to the embryo before the placenta is formed. That's the umbilical cord, which serves as a connection between the fetus and the mother. That's the amniotic fluid in the amniotic cavity that cushions the embryo. It cushions the embryo and the fetus. That's the chorion and that's the amnion. So who was our protector when we were in the wombs of our mother? I leave you with that to ponder about. Thank you everybody for watching this. Just for your perusal, you can just have a look at that. And enjoy the rest of your lives. Peace.